The lair of the Rimarosa lay beneath the dark, twisted ruins known as the Caverns of Madness. Meryn could not shake the feeling that something unimaginably terrible had happened in this place.
Thank you.
pine from the wellspring surrounded her, Merin thought she smelled wild orchids. She closed her eyes and remembered the day, long ago, that she and her mother had made necklaces from the fragrant purple blossoms. And when she reopened her eyes, she no longer felt alone. She was ready to complete her journey.
Thank you.
the hundreds of ships strewn across Skeleton Reef, and the great red tentacles that had dragged her to the bottom of the sea. Soon, she would have to face that creature again. And this time, she would be ready. At last, Merin had reached her destination, the lair of the Rumorosa. She had prepared herself to face anything, and still she wasn't ready for what she saw next. There, trapped inside a diving bell but still alive, was her father. As its mechanical faceplate shattered, the Rimarosa was at last free from the Fomori's control. The creature swooped out of its lair, smashing through the columns of rock beneath the Forbidden City. The heavy city began to collapse under its own weight and fall down into the trench below. Merrin raced to free her father from the diving bell, but the collapsing city was falling down all around her. Merrin grasped her father's hand as an avalanche of debris plummeted toward them. She closed her eyes as the darkness fell over her. When she opened her eyes, there was a roof of green, gleaming scales above her. A giant Queen Leviathan had taken the brunt of the blow from the falling debris. A moment later, a much smaller serpent swam down toward her. It was Swish. "Is this your mother, Swish?" Merrin asked in astonishment. But Swish just wagged his tail and beckoned for her to grab on. She and her father grabbed hold of the two leviathans, and together they swam up, out of the still collapsing debris of the Forbidden City. They swam out of the darkness and into the gleaming rays of sunlight that streaked through the water's surface. And at last, for the first time in what seemed like ages, Merrin and her father looked out over the waves toward their house in the distance. They said goodbye to the pair of leviathans, and Merrin promised to come play with Swish each day in the deep waters below the cliffs. And bit by bit, Merrin's life slowly went back to normal. She and her father traded a few of Merrin's golden coins for a beat-up old fishing boat. Working side by side, they soon had it ready to sail. Merrin no longer had to wait at the cliff's edge. Her father took her out to sea whenever she wanted to go. As they fished, they shared the stories of their own great adventures, both knowing that every word was true. And sometimes, late at night, Merrin thought of all the mysteries she had yet to answer. She thought of Kara, the sea garden, the eggs, and hoped they were all safe. Someday, she thought, someday I will see them again.
Thank you. Thank you.